Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in today's session, we'll discuss about how to draw the histogram chart in a matplotlib. So a histogram is an accurate representation of the distribution of a numerical data. So let us take the numerical data and we can divide the data into different intervals and we can plot the graph that how many values will fall under the particular intervals, right? So let us start so that you will be understand. So here, first of all, we have to import the pyplot module, which is available in the matplotlib library. So for that purpose, I am installing this one from matplotlib import pyplot as PLT. So I am giving some alias name PLT so that we have to call everything by using the PLT. And in order to draw the histogram, so we are supposed to use a function called hist function. And before having the hist function, let us take the values and then the intervals, right? First, let us take the marks of a student. Let us consider the marks of a 10 students. So I'm randomly giving the marks of a 10 students, okay? So, yeah. So I have given some marks of a 10 students. Okay, randomly I have given few marks. Now I will take the intervals. What are the intervals and which intervals we need to specify this one? See, grade intervals, right? So let us take the grade intervals from 0 to 35 is a 1%. I mean, the students who falls in between 0 to 35, there's a fail. And from 36 to some 60 will be the first class. And from 70, let us take some 70. So first class and above 70, there comes under some distinction, right? Let us take these categories. Now I need to divide the complete marks into these intervals. That means how many students comes under this 0 to 35 and 35 to 70 and 70 to 100. For that purpose, I am using the function called histogram, hist. First, we need to take the marks and take the grade intervals, right? And before going to that, we can set the title plt dot set title student grade. Okay, now just go with the show method so that it will display on the screen. Sorry. Yeah, set title. You can see from 0 to 20 there are 3 students. From 0 to 20 there are 3 students. You can see here 0 to 20. Sorry, 0 to, yeah. So we have given some 35. So let us take the x ticks. Okay, so that there will be no confusion. So plt dot x ticks and take the grade intervals from 0, 35, 70 and 100. You can see 0 to 35, 35 to 70 and 70 to 100. So these are the x ticks. So we can change the ticks, right? So this is a function we use to change the ticks. So we can change the ticks. I have changed it to 0 to 35, 35 to 70, 70 to 100. Now you can see 0 to 35, 3 students got are there, 0 to 35. So you can observe here, these are the 3 numbers which are in between 0 to 35. So 3, category 3, you on y axis you can get the 3. So we will give the labels also, plt dot x label. So what is the x label? So x label means this one, percentage, and coming with the y label, it is a number of students, right? So you can get it here, percentage and number of students. In between 0 to 35, 3 students. From 35 to 70, there are around 5 students. 35 to 70, 36, from 36 to 70. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah, only 5 members. So these 5 members falls under 35 to 70 category. And 70 to 100, there are 2 students. 70 to 100, so you can see 90 and 84 comes in between 70 and 100, so 2 students. So like this, we can plot the histogram graph. Okay, and here there are different types of histogram graphs. So for that purpose, we are using another parameter called a hist type. Hist type. If it is a hist type is bar, then it will represent in a bar, right? So here you need to give the R width. So by default it will be 1. So everything will be joined, and if you reduce that one with a 0.7, you can see. So this is a bar. Histogram type is bar. And if you use a step here, then see, you can see this is one type of histogram, step histogram. And also you can go with a step field. Step field. This is a step field. So you can change the colors here, right? By using the phase color attribute. Phase color is equal to, go with the green. See, green. And if you use R, R stands for red. Okay. And K stands for black. Sorry. See, K stands for black. So like this, we can also use a different histogram types. That is a bar histogram, or a step histogram, or step field histogram. Right? If it is a step and step field, we need not require to write the R width. Okay. So if it is a bar type histogram, then we are supposed to use the R width. Okay, if you are not giving this R width, so by default it will be taking as 1 and all the bars will be joined. Okay, you can also go with the colors. Blue color. So hope you understood this one. So if you are having any doubts regarding this histogram graph, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section. Definitely I will try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really enjoyed my session, like my session, share my session with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.